Hello and welcome to the development log of Chronicle Destiny. This is the first one, the first week so far. Basically, I decided for this new year's to start from the beginning, start from scratch, and see if I can apply what I've learned so far in the development of this project. First thing I developed was the GIF recorder. I did this so I can easily share the progress through Twitter and other social media. As a matter of fact, this is the GIF that was recorded, but it is not moving at the proper speed. I grabbed the code from the documentation, and there appears to be an error on the function GIF add surface. There is a delay time setting on the documentation. The value for it is 6 divided by 100, or 6 100ths. But if you change that to 2, it fixes everything. Right now it moves at a proper speed, and I can easily share this GIFs on Twitter. Two features of the GIF recorder: on the bottom left, there is a red dot. It indicates that the GIF recorder is active and recording what's on screen. Also has a counter on the right that basically how many frames it has recorded. And another feature is that it can be switched between a toggle or a hold. The toggle means that I press the button once. The button is actually F12. So I press F12 once and it starts recording, and I press it again and it stops recording. On the hold, pressing hold F12, and while it's being held, it will record what's on the screen. And the yellow ring around the red dot indicates whether it's on toggle or on hold. The next is actual gameplay. It is top-down movement. Basically, this is very, very basic. One common solution is basically subtract the two keys that are being used for the axis. So it'll be like left minus right, or and down minus up. The reason for that is if it turns true when the button is pressed and false when it's not, and those true and false can be interpreted as ones and zeros. So one minus one will equal zero. One minus zero will equal one, and zero minus one will equal negative one. Right? So those give you the values that you need to move from left to right or up and down. But that introduces a quirk. The diagonal movement is actually faster, and I'll get to that. Then the next thing I worked was collisions, right? Making sure that the playable character doesn't go through solid objects. It's pretty simple. It just detects if there's at the given speed. If there's going to be a collision, it just moves it one pixel forward until it actually makes contact with the object. Next was actually a debug view. It's not actually a gameplay feature. They're more to help me develop. On the upper left, there is two values, the x and y value of the playable object. The debug view basically so far allows me to just write like debug add line, put in the what the label is going to be and what the value of that line is going to read. So I put on this one the label is x as a string and I put x as the variable and it prints out x and the value of x, same thing with y. So I mentioned about the diagonal movement earlier, how it is not proper that in fact you move faster in diagonal movement than you do in horizontal and vertical, being that it is the addition of both horizontal and vertical movement. So I've tried to fix it, but clearly there is something wrong. When I move diagonally and contact a wall, I somehow get teleported. After 3 hours of bug hunting, of writing and rewriting, seeing, isolating, and all that kind of stuff, I saw that this value was not what this variable was not the right variable. I had originally written the collision for the horizontal and just copied it and pasted it for the vertical and just switch around the variables to the proper ones for the variable, right? Instead of calculating with the x value, I calculated with the y value. Instead of using HSPD, I use VSPD. But I missed one. And yeah, so that's what was causing the problem. So I corrected that. I replaced HSPD for VSPD, which and now diagonal movement is fixed. On the upper left, for the debug lines, I put what the raw value was for the diagonal movement and the corrected value. Like when it goes diagonal, it goes up to 1.41. That's the basically the speed when moving diagonal, but it gets corrected back down to 1. The next thing I did was actually put an outline around those around that text. That way it is easier to read. And after I did that, basically I implemented the camera, the views, so it follows the playable character and I can now basically make a more expansive gameplay area. So in review, what I did this week so far was the GIF recorder. Again, that's to share the progress through Twitter. The top-down movement, collisions, the debug view, diagonal fix, the outline text, and the camera. The goals for this week is actually start implementing attack. Basically, when you press a button, the hitbox appears, and that will be dependent on direction. NPC, basically, it will be just placing an NPC object. And then is actually the start actually working on basically the hook of this game. And it's gonna start with the dialogue. The dialogue UI, basically just press the button and the dialogue UI appears. Next is gonna be greetings. Basically, you know, when the playable character goes next to the NPC, presses the talk button and starts the dialogue, basically. Then confirmations. basically when the NPC asks a yes or no question, being able to answer yes or no. And the first part of the second part of the hook, interrupts. Basically, the ability to interrupt a dialogue. That means, you know, like when you go to an NPC and start a dialogue, you have to finish it in order to get out of that dialogue. With interrupt, it allows you to essentially cancel the dialogue. Basically interrupt it. So basically those are the goals for next week or for this week. And thanks for watching.